Hello, I am looking at the third question of 2014 exam from the test ELIF. The third question says that assume that the market for honey cakes is competitive and initially the market is in long run equilibrium. Show the initial long run equilibrium both in graph of the market and graph of a firm. Include numbers of your graph. So let's quickly start with this. So let's assume that initially there were 10 firms in the market, the price of the honey was 4, and the quantity sold by each firm was 4. So in all there were 40 quantity being traded at a price of 4, which you can see on the northeast side of your screen. On the left side of your screen you will see that the firm were producing at the minimum of their ATC, and the average total cost and the price at which they sold was equal, so they were not making any profit. Let's look at question two. It says that an unpopular government minister was reported to have said that people should eat cakes, and in response, some people in the country began to boycott the cakes. In the two graphs, can be a new graph from question three. Show how short-run effects. Of introduction of partial boycott. Explain what happens to the price of honey cakes in the market, quantity sold in the market, the quantity of honey sold by each firm, and the profit that each firm will make to sell the honey. So this was initial market, and suddenly the demand decreased because people just started boycotting the demand. So when people started to boycott the product, the demand curve moved left. So at 6 price, if they were demanding like 20, now they are demanding just 1 or 2, like or at 2 earlier they were demanding like 50, but now they are just demanding 40. So the demand decreased. At the same price, people want to buy less, so demand curve moved left, and the short-term equilibrium saw that the price fell down, and the quantity sold also fell down. So in the short run, we saw that the price in the market went down because people were not buying, the quantity sold down because nobody was buying. Again, the same logic. But the average total cost of a company to produce is increased to 4.5. So not just that, they have to sell at a lower price, the price to produce has also increased, so it's a two-way loss. And what would happen in the reverse is what we did in the cake. So the unpopular government, Mr. Bisanath government, all and during the long term, some people in the country boycott all cakes. In two graphs, show the long-term equilibrium. So this thing persisted, and people did not change. So the market has to find its new equilibrium now because this guy who caused the boycott survived, and people are still boycotting the product. So if that would happen, then we will have a long-term equilibrium. So in the long run equilibrium, since the demand decreased, the supply also decreased because it was very difficult for people to sell at those pricing. So some of the players left in the market, which caused a reduction in the supply. So if like at 4 earlier they were supplying 40, now they are going to just supply 20. So that's what exactly what has happened now. So since it was very difficult for the companies to survive in the new rain, the supply decreased, and the supply decreased and went to a place where everything was efficient again, and they were producing 4 because that was the sweet spot for them, and the market also was buying it at 4. And the number of firms in the market decreased. So decrease in demand caused a decrease in supply, but only the efficient players are in the market who can produce the cheapest at 4 at the at a spot where they are like most efficient, because if you ask them to produce on either side, it's expensive for them. So they are at their best spot, and since it's a competitive market, they can only sell the product at four. So this is how the dynamics would look like.